Today, we're going to talk about how to use the reward model to improve the quality of video generation. First of all, the reward model is not a new concept for everyone. It was first proposed as a mechanism in enhancement learning or reinforcement learning. Simply put, it's about rewarding for doing right and punishing for doing wrong. Speaking of feedback models, we must mention a team, Alibaba's PAI team. You should be familiar with this team. The well-known fun model was developed by them. Starting from 1.1, we have extensively introduced the usage of the feedback model. Similarly, after the 1.2.2 model was released, the feedback model also received a synchronous upgrade. Today, we will use 7 practical examples to demonstrate the role of rewards. Lora, and you will clearly see how it affects video generation. In this video, we will also explain in detail some of its techniques during actual use. I have built all the workflows on Running Hub. You can visit the platform through runninghub.ai in the ComfyUI domain. Running Hub is an excellent workbench because as soon as new models and extensions are developed, Running Hub will follow up immediately. Now, let's elaborate on the use of the feedback model. What you are seeing now is a page for the feedback model on Hugging Face. Looking at its name, it's called Reward Lora, so its manifestation is a Lora model. On this page, you can see that there are about 4 sets of models. Some might ask why there are 4 sets. It's easy to understand. Firstly, as everyone knows, 1.2.2 has both e-noise models and low-noise models, so there should be at least 2 sets. Additionally, there are 2 different types of feedback models. One is called HPS, and the other is called MPS. Some might ask what the difference is between HPS and MPS. As reward models, you can simply understand that they reward different dimensions. Essentially, neither is inherently better or worse. You can simply assume that after using the MPS reward model, the video will have a stronger sense of motion. When using the HPS model for rewards, the video will have more details. Based on these 2 characteristics, we will also find that MPS seems to be more suitable for high-noise models, while HPS is more suitable for low-noise models. This conclusion is also confirmed on the official website. There's a description here. Please take a look. We found that the MPS feedback Lora is not particularly significant in low-noise models, and it is very slow when executing. Therefore, the official recommendation is to use HPS Rewards Lora for low-noise models. There are some examples below if you are interested. Furthermore, there is another very important piece of information on the official website. When generating videos, the model weights used are both 0.5, not the traditional 0.8 or 1. This is also something to pay attention to when building your workflows. Alright, once we have this information, we can build our own workflow. Let's first look at the basic composition of the workflow. First, there's the model loading section, high noise model and low noise model. At the same time, I also loaded an acceleration model. Then, you should note that in the high noise model, I am currently using our MPS reward Lora. In the low noise model, I am currently using HPS Lora. The weights I've set for both are 0.5, which is consistent with the official website's description. Then, we loaded the text compiler NV. Below is the prompt section, which we won't go into detail about. Next is the sampling section. For the sampling part, there are 2 groups. Please note that I also saved 2 sets of models here. One with reward, Lora added, and the other without. What you are seeing now in this sampling step is where we used reward Lora. I've displayed the sampling results here, and this one is without using reward Lora, which I've displayed here. Let's briefly discuss the basic sampling parameters. Firstly, all the videos I generated are in landscape format, because landscape format contains more visual information, allowing us to see more differences when comparing. Next, the basic parameters for high and low sampling are the same. However, we need to clarify the issue of seeds. To allow everyone to compare the differences in generation models on the same standard, please note that I used seed 42 for all high-noise models and seed 0 for all low-noise models. This way, we can ensure that the initial noise distribution is the same. Any subsequent differences will then stem from the differences in the models. Alright, now that we understand this workflow, let's take a look at what the differences are between not using reward Lora and using reward Lora. Firstly, what we can intuitively see is that the actions are more beautiful, and the details are also richer. For example, please note that here, there's a very beautiful shimmering light effect, but this one doesn't have it. Look at this lantern, it's also more beautiful. Now look at this dull and lifeless one. Additionally, there's a very obvious difference in the fairy's dress. Please note that this is a peacock's tail, while this one, although also a peacock tail, it's not pretty enough. So, it can achieve some improvements in details. Furthermore, please note that there are also some improvements in color. There's something like a mechanical crane arm here. After using Reward Lora, notice that its color is red. Whereas if you look at this one, it has a relatively dull color. Another issue is the actions. Please take a look. The actions of this character are more aesthetically pleasing. This one is a bit lacking, isn't it? So, it's clear that when we use Reward Lora, there's a significant improvement in color, details, and the aesthetic appeal of the actions. Of course, one example isn't enough to illustrate the full picture. Let's look at the second example. Similarly, this is the case without using the feedback Lora, and this one is after using the feedback Lora. Let's compare them again. Please take a look. Firstly, the colors here are brighter, while this one is a bit dull, isn't it? Additionally, the details are also different. We can compare. For example, look at this spa. Here, there's a clear effect of splashing debris. But if you look at this one, it's absent. Similarly, it's also missing here. Additionally, you should note the details of the marble below. This is a double-layered design with clear textures, whereas this one is quite simple and rough. There are also some differences in the background. For instance, after using Reward Lora, there will be obvious buildings here, but this spot doesn't have them. Also, regarding the actions, you'll notice that this person's movements are very aesthetically pleasing and beautiful. Look at this person's movements, especially the action of squatting with bent legs, which appears very clumsy, obviously. I can sync them up. Everyone, take a look. Let's use another example. This is a dragon-riding female warrior holding a long spear. First, let's look at the colors. This one is brighter, while this one is a bit duller. Let's examine the details. Please note that this character is wearing a dragon-shaped helmet, whereas this one is not. Additionally, regarding the dragon's details, it will have more textures and more layers, resulting in better quality. Through these three examples, we can clearly state that the feedback model indeed helps in video generation regarding details, colors, and character actions. What else is there besides this? Let's look at another example. This example is to illustrate that the feedback model also plays a role in correcting minor incorrect actions. Please note that when the feedback model was not used, this character exhibited the very common issue of walking backward. However, after using the feedback model, its actions are normal. Moreover, we will find that its color, actions, and details are indeed better. Reward Lora also has another very important function, that is, limiting the range of motion. As we all know, the wan2.2 model tends to exaggerate actions a bit. So, if you sometimes feel its movements are too large, Rewards Lora can effectively suppress this issue. Please note, this is a scene in the desert. This girl has a pair of wings, and fire is coming out of them. When Reward Lora is not used, notice that the actions are not beautiful. The wings feel weak and powerless, and her silk ribbons also don't look good. But look at this one. The wings have more details. The colors are brighter, and the silk ribbons behind her are also more vibrant in color. Moreover, this girl also wears a very beautiful crown on her head. This is one of the features of Reward Lora that we mentioned earlier. But there's another point. Please observe. Here, she appears to be jumping, but in this one, she isn't. Therefore, these large-scale movements are suppressed by Reward Lora, which is also a very important function of it. However, Reward Lora cannot solve some inherent problems that exist in the models themselves. For example, everyone, take a look. This is a common issue we encounter when generating videos. Somersaults. Although using Reward Lora improves the texture of the train and the effect of the character, when it flips over, it still cannot solve the problem of deformation. Its legs just wrap around directly, without a specific flipping motion. Therefore, for such inherent shortcomings and problems of the model, these small correction models cannot fully fix them. Similarly, there is a very important issue here. Because it was initially invisible, when it appeared, it was a mermaid's tail. Logically, it should have been a complete tail. But this situation occurred. Although using Reward Lora improved many details, colors, and actions, this problem remains unresolved. However, there's also a very noticeable improvement here. Please note that below this is water, while below this is sand. So, through these seven examples, we have demonstrated the specific advantages and disadvantages of using the feedback model, which is Reward Lora. Alright, what are you waiting for? Go try it yourself, now. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.